Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. It's Eva from Bohemian Crafting and today I'm coming to share with you process video of this double envelope plus triple pocket or maybe more pockets for which are made like a belly band. So here is pocket, here is pocket, here is pocket. And we do have those, those two envelopes. It's very easy to make it. It's lots of fun. I used one 12 by 12 sheet of paper. I used Tim Holtz, of course, you can see that. I love these papers, they are so gorgeous. I used some book pages and I used envelope. And the process video is coming now. And it looks very beautiful. If you will add, you know, papers inside, and maybe papers around, so this will be like peeking out from your signature. You can then sew it to your journals. I hope you will like this process video. I did enjoy it so much. I'm so happy in my craft room now. So I'm gonna swap the view of my camera and we will create something together. So I've got here one 12 by 12 paper. This is from Tim Holtz collection. One DL envelope, window envelope, and two book pages, and I'm gonna create some insert for inserts, some pockets for inserts. And I was thinking double pocket, which you can slide between your papers and then sewn into your book. And I wanna have it a little bit decorative, that way I should say. So first, I think I'm gonna work on that envelope. I already showed this to my Patreons. It's kind of belly band. So this envelope has this sticky strip and I'm gonna use that sticky strip like my measurement. But you can use any DL envelope and score it 3 inches from the bottom. I'm gonna just fold it over and it's actually 3 inches, this one. So if you do have DL envelope, score it from the bottom of that envelope 3 inches. You don't have to have their window, but if you do have their window, make sure that scoring will don't go over your window. And I'm gonna cut this one because it's too long, about that big. I'm just gonna use this piece to reinforce this side. So now I'm gonna cut the size where I do have that window, because I wanna have that window on the top. I'm gonna make belly band and I wanna have this window on the top of that belly band. So I'm gonna cut this side close to that window and the bottom of my envelope. So I'm gonna kind of open that envelope like a book. Just teeny meeny slide. So now I can open that envelope this way. And this will be entry to my pocket. So I wanna use this fold to reinforce that top. And I'm also gonna glue this one to make sure it will stay still. So I'm gonna put the glue here. And it's just to make sure that, because all this will be like entry to pockets, this side. So I'm gonna put that glue and kind of reinforce that edge to make it stronger. This doesn't have to be here. And now you can take scoring board, or if you do have same or similar envelope like I do, I'm gonna just fold it the way where this side, I'm gonna kind of create same measurement on that opposite side to make nice even frame. I will tell you how big it is. So So I folded it 5. I'm good. So you can score at 5 and fold it, and then that opposite end I'm just gonna fold here and keep between, just small gap between those two, just teeny mini small gap, and I'm gonna fold it. I'm gonna put glue here and here and glue it straight away. Put glue here and here on the bottom to that fold and fold it back and glue it. And I'm gonna fold it behind that edge. Fold it again so it should sit exactly like this. So I do have my base. Now I'm gonna move to my 12 by 12 paper. And I'm gonna cut the strip of that paper. I think this is 3, so 3 and 1 quarter. I'm gonna cut 3 and 1 quarter, just a small bit. I'm gonna take that strip. Put glue here, not too close to that edge of this fold. So glue here and on the bottom. And here. I'm gonna take my 3 1/4 inch strip and glue it right on it. And still will try to keep small gap between those two to make sure this can be folded over easy with no, you know, with no those bulky thingy. So glue it. Here I'm gonna take my scissors and cut this. And I'm gonna take my sewing machine and I'm gonna sew this side. I'm gonna show you this way. This side, all that bottom where it's glued here, and also I'm gonna sew here and here where it's fold. So all this, all the bottom, and then this fold. And here this edge of this paper. So I do have this one. Sewn all that bottom and here, here and here. And I'm gonna take that off cut. And I'm gonna create kind of holder with decorative effect. So you do have off cut like this. The measurement is how many? 1.5 by 3 1/4. So that side 1.5, I'm gonna punch the corners with my envelope punch board to make it looks like that. Okay. So I'm gonna punch just one, and second one I'm gonna cut with my scissors. Yeah, it's gone. Those opposite corners I'm gonna try to cut with this corner punch. Good. Yay, we did it. And it will be placed here. So it can be like a slight spot and it will be peeking out right here. But before I will do that, I'm gonna do not forget to do these corners a little bit more decorative on that decorative paper, not on envelope. And I'm gonna not try to use my envelope punch board. I'm just gonna take my scissors, and with my scissors you can use any kind of corner punch, or same like me, use your scissors and create tabs. Here got one, and that opposite side, maybe I can keep it all just following that envelope and up and create tap, up and tap. Okay, I'm gonna probably save these. What I've got there, some letters. So now I'm gonna take my crocodile and I'm gonna punch two holes here, no matter how far from each other. And I'm gonna use that 3/16 of hole punch on the crocodile and punch two holes. Like this. I didn't even measure it, just, you know, to make it looks nice-ish. So it looks like this. Now I'm gonna fold this, place my tab under the way I would like to see it. I'm gonna take pencil and draw the holes here, or you know where I do have those holes. And with that 1/8, with that smaller punch, I'm gonna punch those holes, or you know, those marks. Like this. I'm not sure if you can see. Hopefully you can see. I'm gonna take a piece of string and of course some distress ink to make it a little bit more decorative, look a little bit more vintage. So I'm gonna use a walnut stain distress ink and distress all these edges. Maybe I will use this one. Then I'm gonna place through. Now you're gonna be here. Okay. I should have a look before. I would rather use that other image, but because I already punched those holes, I have to use this one because it's on the right spot. But before you will punch those holes, make sure you have this piece the way you want to see it. It will be a little bit different than I thought. So here I'm gonna wrap the knot, or make a knot to make sure it will stay still. I'm gonna add two eyelets into these holes. So I have fixed the eyelets, and I'm gonna take this small piece again. I'm gonna close this side, so I do have my belly band, and I'm gonna put the string or that Utah twin or what is it through and wrap it here before I will glue it. I need to make sure it will be on the right spot, so I'm gonna wrap it here, make a nice position of the way I would like to see this tab. I'm gonna take a glue and put a glue here. A little bit, and here on the top, on this top, I'm gonna place a glue here on the top and just close that, make a nice press, make sure it's straight. Now I'm gonna unwrap it. Here, hold that tab and open that window part. And I'm gonna make sure that here it's kind of straight. This one. And I'm gonna let it dry. So once it's dry, I will have nice belly band with one slight spot here. Pocket here, pocket behind this, and pocket here with window, and beautiful design inside. So I'm gonna place it on the side, and I'm gonna go back. I'm gonna let it dry and decorate it a little bit more, but right now I'm gonna go back to this offcut kind of ish. I'm gonna take my scoring board. And I'm gonna score this on first on those long sides. I'm gonna score 1/2 inch from each side, so 1/2 inch here, and 1/2 inch here. You can flip it over. And if you did same cut, so it's 1/2 inch and then 8 1/4. Or you can do 1/2 inch here, then flip it over and do again 1/2 inch. And then I'm gonna place it this way. And on this long side of those 12 inches, I'm gonna score 1 1/2. Come on, sit down. 1 1/2. Six, and 10 1/2. I'm gonna fold at that 6 score line, and here where I do have those cross lines from that 1/2 inch here and that 1 1/2 inch here, I'm gonna cut to the cross. And from that cross, I'm going kind of in the angle, not straight. I'm not gonna copy the score line, but I'm gonna go kind of a little bit in the angle to create envelope flap shape. Same, I'm gonna do on that opposite side. First to that cross. Here is that cross. And from that cross, kind of in the little bit in angle. Not gonna follow this score line. Here is nicely to see. But I'm gonna go kind of this way and create envelope flap. Maybe it will be not exactly same like on that opposite side, but you know, it's handmade. And do not forget where we have that fold. So here from the score line, I'm gonna cut just the corner. Same here, just cut corner to that score line. to make sure that these can be fold here and here, and you will don't have bulk here in the middle. Like this. So I do have base for my envelopes. And now I need to finish those envelopes. So for that, I'm gonna use my book pages. I do have these book pages a little bit longer, I think. Yeah, they are a little bit longer. So I'm gonna cut the book page. I'm gonna measure how big I need it. And they are bigger, which is good because that book page is not strong. So I need to reinforce the entry. So I'm gonna measure how long I need it. And cut these book pages to make them a little bit shorter to fit them to my envelope base. Where is my guillotine? There you are. I'm gonna cut those two book pages exactly same because it's same measurement for both envelopes. And here I'm gonna choose which one I want. Yeah, full print. And I think, aha, okay, this way. I'm gonna place my book page close to that middle fold, but to make sure I'm not over that middle fold. And I'm gonna fold this the way I can see the entry to my envelope. And I think I will need to use some scoring tools probably, or maybe not. It looks same. It looks straight, so I'm gonna take other one. I will place it there. I like that Tim holds paper, so I probably will place it there this way. Good. Yeah, I guess this way. Will I keep this on the top? Probably yes. Oh, no, this one. So here I'm gonna take measurement from this first book page and fold it exactly same. So one will be here and one will be here. Like that ripped edge. Maybe I will keep it that way. So first I would like to have some stitching on this base. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna stitch because that book page is very very fragile, so I'm not gonna do stitching on that book page because I'm not gonna ruin it. I'm gonna do stitching here, here, here and here, and maybe all over of that base as well. So I have made that zigzag stitching on these folds. And all over, I made just straight stitching all over of this piece. And I add zigzag stitching also on the edges of these book pages here and here. So now I'm gonna start to put it somehow together. I'm gonna fold it back. Take my ruler and find the middle or in the flap so I can add there. I can add there, I think I'm gonna fold it to make sure I do have middle, add their eyelets. So I'm gonna find the middle here, kind of middle in middle, somewhere here. I'm gonna fold it together and punch the hole. Through to both those flaps. Gonna take, yeah, this way. That book page, place it where it will be after I will glue it down, so it will be here. Fold this. And I think somewhere here. Here. Because these book pages are pretty much very fragile, like really fragile. I'm gonna reinforce them just with some simple cardstock. I've got here so many of these. So I'm gonna find two cards, if I will find two cards. Or I can take book page actually. I don't have two of them. I should. I do. To make it stronger, you know, to make sure it will hold properly, I'm gonna just glue it inside two cards. I think it will be somewhere here to cover the middle part of that insert. So like this, I got them glued. I'm gonna place them back to back together to make sure the hole will be on the right position. So back to back with those cards glued on it. And I'm gonna punch the hole where I made that huge mark. So I'm gonna try to make it kind of in the middle of that mark. Hopefully that will work. Right here. And I'm gonna fix to all these. All these. I'm gonna fix the circles. But these small ones. Oh, I can maybe use these offcuts. You've got here these offcuts from those corners. So maybe I can use that. So I have managed to punch four circles using 1.6 centimeters circle punch. I think it's kind of 3/4 inch-ish, I guess. It will be 3/4 inch. So I've got four circles. I'm gonna punch the hole in the middle of them. Hopefully I will punch it straight. Gonna try. Yeah, done it. And it's in the middle. I'm impressed. So I'm gonna fix the eyelet and fix it together, one circle to each book page, and then I will move to those flaps. So here is one, and here is second one. So I do have these book pages. And now, why I'm placing that? Now these flaps. So I'm gonna take the circle eyelet. I'm gonna cut two strings. Oi! Oopsla! I think that big will be enough. About how many? Oh, 13 inches. Look at me. Is it? Yeah, it's longer than my envelope. About 13 inches I've got string. So maybe it will be too long. I will see. I'm gonna slide the string in. Place there the eyelet with that paper circle. And fix it. Like this. And I will do same on that opposite side. Put the string first, then the circle with eyelet. And oh, and find the eyelet and then fix it. I found the eyelet on my bed. It was jump far away. So now I can glue these inside. So I'm gonna put a glue here on the bottom. Here on the bottom. And place it next to that score line in the middle. Then I'm gonna put the glue here on this flap. Just to that part where I do have the book page, not here on the end, but just here till the end of that book page. And fold it over. Let it dry. Same I'm gonna do with that opposite. I can move this already. So just till the end of the book page, somewhere here. Fold it over and let it dry. And same I'm gonna do on the other side. Hold, come on, hold. I do have that circle here. I need to lift it up a little bit. Yeah, and that string is quite long. So I'm gonna cut that string and I'm gonna use the rest somewhere on the tuck. This is enough. It's holding. And I really like this book page here. I didn't glue it till the end. I'm kind of keeping it, that edge kind of ripped off. And I really like that look. So I'm gonna put the glue here on the bottom. Place it here. Put the glue here. Or I can put glue on that book page, it doesn't matter. On the book page. And fold these. And let it dry. Let it sit down and dry. And glue it together nicely. I think here I will need to add a little bit more glue. Probably I didn't add there enough. And it's kind of getting and down. I'm gonna close this. Nice. Lift it up a little bit, that circle. Oh, come on. Lift yourself. Good. And again, I'm gonna cut that string. It's quite long. So I do have my two envelopes. Now I can slide it between my papers. So it will look like this. Here can be papers, here can be papers. So put it inside in your signature and sew it to your book. And where is that? Ah, there is this one. And what I was thinking about this belly band, I can use this back side. First, I'm gonna have a look how far it goes. So if I will glue it here. Yeah, I do have quite big space here, so I'm gonna use my stamp. And I do love numbers. It always looks like some documentation, and it's kind of like, you know, I wanna dig in it and to see what kind of document is there. So I'm gonna stamp here. Am I on right? Yes, I'm right. Stamp here. The number. You can find any kind of these numbered stamps on eBay, on Etsy, on Amazon. And now I can glue it in. Yeah. I like it. So I'm gonna put the glue on all this backside, on all this pocket, because I will actually have that pocket right here. This will be my pocket, and because this is behind that, it will be invisible. So I'm gonna glue all this side down on that page. Or if you want to create another pocket, put the glue just here, here and here. And then you will have pocket from this side where is the where that number is. And I'm going to just glue it here. So that way you do have nice pocket here. And I do have pocket here, and I do have pocket here. And if I will don't put all glue all on that space there, and just here and here and here on that space there, I mean, I will have another pocket from here, but I put there a lot of glue. So I'm gonna finish it from now. I should think about it before I glue that down. Well, next time. So now I do have many pockets and also belly band, which can hold another things. I'm gonna close it together. And I do have here these. This is what I can do with you. Where is that stamp? Maybe I can stamp this one as well. Just one more number. And because there is that number, I'm gonna use the same number here. Which one I'm gonna use? This is nicely aged like this. Fold it behind that number. Here is acetate piece, so I'm gonna use double-sided tape for gluing it down. like this, and I've got these offcuts. I had somewhere one more, right? Ah, here is it. This is kind of smaller one. And I'm gonna place it right here. So it's nicely matching that background inside of that envelope. And this I think I'm gonna save for next time. So this is my sharing for today. I'm gonna find some nice ephemeras and add them to these pockets. Or maybe I will find some more stamps and do some stamping and make some ephemeras. I will see. But I really like this look, you know, that old book page and Tim Holtz papers, they are always gorgeous. And this number here, and if you will slide it around or in your papers, do I have some papers? I don't have here any signature right now, unfortunately. I have here. No, I glue it. It's all glued. And this is not that wide. If you will imagine, you will have here papers, like your papers, and it will peeking out behind them. It will be amazing. So, this is my sharing for today. I hope you did enjoy it. I've got loads of those 12 by 12 papers, and I didn't use them at all. Which is so shame, because they are gorgeous. But I always felt like I don't want to cut them, you know. I want to just have a look on them, or look at them, because they are so beautiful. So this is my small sharing, small insert to your inserts. I hope you are all well, and I hope you take good care about yourself. Thank you so, so much for visiting me today. Have a wonderful time. Take care about yourself, and see you next time. Bye.